Last week, Zambia's social media was dominated by chatter over comments attributed to veteran broadcaster and communications expert Mr. Chibamba Kanyama, who is said to have labeled morning radio show hosts as childish. And as you'd expect, a lot of people came out in support of those sentiments. Coming up, I want to show you just how, where, and why I think the former DG of ZNBC may have missed the mark. This is Unpopular Opinion, and I am Langa Mwene. First things first, Mr. Kanyama is a highly experienced and accomplished media practitioner. He has years, decades actually, of experience under his belt, having worked in both the private and public sector. Among his notable achievements, there's an award for best radio production in Africa. Then we also saw him rise to the position of DG of ZNBC. So if anyone is qualified to speak on matters relating to media and radio in particular, clearly it would be him. So additionally, Mr. Kanyama also runs a business consultancy where he offers media training to journalists across the SADC region. And apparently, it was at one of such training sessions that he made the comments that have now become the focus of this whole debate. The renowned media trainer is quoted to have said that mature adults do not find listening to morning radio interesting anymore, and so they opt to switch to the BBC. He then doubled down on those sentiments during an appearance he made on QFM's breakfast show. He appears to expect that radio stations of today must still go out of their way to try and cater to all audience segments. But trying to appeal to everyone in this day and age is neither ideal nor practical. During the days when he worked in radio at ZNBC, ZNBC enjoyed monopoly. They were probably the only media house in the nation. It might have been vital back then to try and appeal to as wide an audience as possible. Because after all, ZNBC is a public good supplemented by taxpayers. But today's independent radio stations survive solely on advertising. So it's essential that they make it clear to their advertisers what sort of audience they will deliver. Clearly, what Mr. Kanyama finds as childish is drawing listenership, because we are seeing these radio hosts also growing a following on social media. Of course, they will not appeal to everyone, and that's fine. No one is commanded to listen to these radio shows. Actually, as he stated himself, for those that are more mature, they may find content that's more relatable and maybe more meaningful if they listen to a radio station like the BBC. But I will tell you that that too is frustrating, because I found that the BBC tries to be all things to all people in all countries. Listeners are frequently subjected to content that is meant for like another area, so it may not be relevant to you as you listen. And that is how the BBC lost me as a listener. And if local radio stations try to appease everyone, they too will start losing their listenership. Those that know their audiences, like Comboni Radio, for example, must stick to their formula and keep attracting advertisers who are most interested in reaching that specific audience. In conclusion, Mr. Kanyama was right that there's hardly any content on radio today for mature listeners. Should there be? I think so too. But I would say if that segment or niche was lucrative enough, you can bet that someone would have been looking to profit from it, including Mr. Chibamba Kanyama himself. But if it is not, we just have to get used to BBC. Thank you for watching.